This conference will now be recorded.
So if you see here, if you click this data, you can see that there is only one data source, this orders. Okay, if you want to add new data source, if you remember, I was teaching you this icon when we started this icon, or you can go here, both are same only. So I'll click this. Let's assume that I'm connected to a different file. So EU supposed to. So this could be your new data source or your detail table. Okay, so let's assume that you have a summary table and you want to connect to a detail table. So you just connect to the data source, go to a new worksheet. So you could see there are two data layers now, or two data source now. So let's assume this is your summary and this is your detail, and you create some charts. Let's say it can be as detailed as possible. So it's up to you. Something simple.
Different data source, right? Is it possible to provide navigation?
Only if they have the common field names, that's it. If they have the same name, so let's say customer name.
Yeah,
customer
they have common field.
Yeah, the spelling should be matching. If it is matching, then WHF will take it. I need to work for you. Spelling should be matching, that's it. Nothing else. So this C3, right? Which is nothing.
Filters we would like to pass. Whatever, if I click on one measure, if whatever fields or filters I want to pass it, those filters should be with the same name in both the data sources, right?
Yes, exactly.
Okay. Shall we discuss actions again? I think I forgot how to create. You have to apply to all the worksheets. Okay.
Yes, you have to.
We'll discuss
here.
Actions more and challenges.
Today that's what the plan. So you understood what I did for C3, right? It's a different data source, but maybe a similar field. Just for us to understand, I'm just trying the similar field. Okay. So I'll go back to summary dashboard. I'll drag and drop the C3 and I'll place it here at the bottom. Okay. So for now, if you see, they are same, but providing this can be as detailed as possible, this can be summary. Okay. So what, as you see, the spelling source kind of matching region, segment. Okay. So to create an action filter, I just spoke about the shortcut, click on a sheet and click on this users filter. So first time, if you see this funnel kind of icon, right? The filter kind of icon will not be initiated. You have to click it.
Yeah.
If you click it, that funnel will be shaded, which means this particular sheet will be acted as a action filter or filter action for the other sheets, the other two sheets. Okay. So if
one
you go to the
second, click on filter icon.
Yeah, filter icon. It can come this side or it can come this side, but this icon. Remember this icons, the three icons. This is for removing, this is for go to sheet. This is for a users filter. So you have to click this users filter.
Okay, today I have to try this then. Yesterday they told I, but I was doing very slowly, but taking time to do formatting, coloring, fonting, everything and all.
Understand.
Yesterday they said with this speed it is difficult, they were saying. I have to, because still I'm learning only, right? I think I didn't learn only actually.
When you try once or twice, at least like three times, right, then you should be faster. So it's okay, it happens. They will say you're slow, then they'll say you're the fastest, so don't worry, it happens.
Okay,
so this thing you got, right, this users filter. So now showing you how it works. So let me click on central consumer. So as soon as I click on central consumer, both the sheets are getting applied. This particular sheet is coming from different data source, but still the filter is getting applied because the name of those fields were matching. Okay. So it is working fine here.
Okay.
So this is a way where if you have all the tables in a single view, you can do like this. Okay. So let's assume, what if the sheet 3 is in a different dashboard? Okay, usually, right? Like if you think there's a space, it's good to have the retail table in the same dashboard itself, okay? But if you think there is no space here, or you want to have it in a different dashboard where you
Yeah,
are giving a more.
definitely it would. Yeah, please tell me. Definitely it would be a different table. Detail, it means a tabular view. It contains all the
Different
details.
dashboard,
So,
different tab, different dashboard, right?
yeah, it would be different dashboard in that case. Yeah,
Okay, so
yeah.
let's remove this from this view. Okay, I'll remove this. I'll go to a new dashboard, I'll create a new dashboard. I'll drag and drop the sheet 3. Maybe for now, I'll make it automatic. Let's make it fit width for now. Okay, if you want, I will just make it simple table also.
Okay,
just a table. Let's click some product
okay.
names to just show you that this can be detailed. So I'm just trying some detail level, okay? Something like this. Bigger. Okay, so let me call this as detail table. Detail tab maybe, or detail. Drill down, what they usually say is drill down. Okay, I'll just call this drill down, okay? And I'll go to the summary dashboard. This time, I cannot just rely on this icon because this icon will work only within dashboard.
Okay.
If you want to move from one dashboard to dashboard,
okay.
I have to go and edit the option. So yesterday you remember, right? Dashboard, actions, this filter, okay? So this filter, this is the one used for this.
Second,
horizontal.
Second. Where are you going? Dashboard?
Dashboard, actions.
Again.
Yeah,
action.
Dashboard, actions. You'll get this window. Where you can see that different actions, filter action is created. Table itself is automatically created for you. Okay, so this filter one generated, right? That is only for this sheet. So I can see in the source, right? Summary dashboard, region sales. That region sales is nothing but this sheet. So let's me edit it. Click, double click it, or you can click it and say edit. Either way will work out. So to get the detail window or edit window of this particular option. So I'll double click it. I'll get this window. So here, if you see the source target, right? So let the source be region sales. So in the target, you're seeing summary dashboard, these two sheets. So what I'm going to do is that click this drop down, click on this drill down, and sheet is automatically selected.
Okay.
So not selected, you just select it, but it will be usually selected. So what I'm saying Tableau right now is that when someone clicks on region sales, apply a filter action on the target, on the tab drill down or on the dashboard drill down.
Okay.
Nothing else
okay.
is here. I'll talk about these things later, but you are getting this right. So first it was in summary dashboard and selected like this, but instead of that, I'm just clicking on drill down. So which will, I think the source is this and targeted this. So what Tableau is going to do is like from there, it's going to go to this drill down screen. With those fields applied as a filter action. Make sense?
Okay.
I'll show you. I'll give OK and OK. So as soon as you click on central consumer, so if you see it's only central consumer. So even if you scroll down, you'll see only central consumer here because Tableau is applying that as a filter and you are seeing different product name because I added that. So you can kind of see like a detailed view. So assuming that that would be your task name or something, whatever details you want. Okay, so those detail columns, those detail columns. Okay, so those detail columns, I can hear you. Those detail columns, right? They can be as a new column. So let's say product name does not really exist on summary dashboard. It's fine. It's only the filter fields which you're gonna send should be there with the right. Yeah, that's you can have more columns. Tableau doesn't care whether it has or not. But remember that this is like master, this is like detail. Okay, so whatever things or whatever fields you're gonna send, the name and spelling should be matching. Other than that, you can make it any chart, any view, any number of new columns, any measures. It's not a big deal here. The spelling doesn't really care because Tableau can send only the dimensions as a filter everywhere, not just Tableau, but everywhere. We'll add the dimensions as filters. Okay.
Okay. For this detail report, from summary to detail counts should match, right? I want to enable grand total also. in the detail.
Okay, so for grand total, right, click this table, click on this analysis, totals, show column grand total. So this is a column which is going, right, or try to show if you're confused which one to go. If you click on column grand total, at the bottom you will see the grand total. So it came only when I clicked this analysis tools, show
table.
Column grand
analysis
total.
Table
totals, totals analysis totals,
column grand,
column grand totals.
If I want a grand total on the top, means
click on this column totals to top,
column totals on top
to top. Oh, yeah, okay. You'll see at the top.
Okay.
So these are the two options which you have. Okay, and if you want subtotal, you have to click this icon or add all subtotals.
Mm-hmm.
So if I click it, it's gonna give me for central what's the total. So like in our case, we have the central consumer, so you kind of see the repeated ones. But assuming, let me show you multiple selection. So I'll just select multiple things so you could see. Just give me a second. I think there's a filter. Just give me a second.
Consumer, central, and east, you have selected.
Yeah, I selected two. It's a bit different. Do I have any filter here? Once again, what's on? Is this showing the same? I'm just worried. Only one word is getting going there. It'll be quiet. Okay, I got it. It's because this particular data, right, it doesn't have east data. That's why. This. Maybe let's try. Central, say central. I'll press control and south. So now I think you should be seeing south. Yeah, you're seeing south now. Okay. So you can see central.
What's the reason? I didn't understand.
No. It is because we do not have the, let's say, I'll show you this. I'll go to new feed. If you go to region, right?
Oh, we do not have east region.
Yeah, we do not have east region in this particular data set. I rarely use this data set, but as I said, there's some request that we do not have east. Okay, so as I tried south, right, so all I did is just come back, press control and selected the other region. So as soon as I selected the south, you could see in the bottom, you could see here. So the central total is 911, but the grand total is 1206. If you start to work, it is coming from south central, I mean south consumer.
Okay.
Try to get that. I'm just trying to get the south consumers total. Yeah, 295. So that 911 and 295 is giving us total of 1206. Okay. So that's how you do it, by going to this dashboard actions here. So instead of, it will be mostly the same sheet. Instead of that, you just click on the other sheet or other dashboard. So Tableau will send that whatever value you click here will be passed as a filter to the other tab or other dashboard. Got it?
Okay. Yeah, got it.
Yeah.
So
tell him, mm-hmm.
So two data sources, I have to add it now. Okay, Rajiv. Actually, what I feel is like it would be better if I get the WebEx recordings on that day itself, because my work has already started, right? I would be like, you know, it would be helpful to refer it once. Yesterday, I discussed with you on TAOPEN and then rank function. Then later, all of a sudden, I missed information. Then later I did Google and then I remembered and then I have completed that one. That view I have completed. Top 10 tasks which is getting failed frequently. Whose status is followed.
Okay.
So if I get the recordings handy, then quickly I'll be able to get it right. So that's why.
Okay, I'll check with them.
Can you please check with that?
Yeah, I'll check with them. Usually they give at the very end. after the course is completed or something like that. I'll check with them. I may end up saving it somewhere. I'm saving it in my Google.
That they can make it as one CD. Yeah, they can make it in one CD and then that they can do it. At least the you know, the important topics which I ask you like this, right? At least on that day, not all the days, at least one important topics which we discussed on particular day. If you could send it, that would be helpful for that day.
Sure, I'll check with them and get back to you today. Like, it's just nothing much. I'm just sending one link which has all the videos. I'm kind of adding those to the particular Google Drive. Okay, so let's see. I'll just check with them. If they're fine, I'll send you the link. So shall I move on?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, great. So here, right, the few options if you want to talk here. This setting we spoke yesterday, but we did not really talk about this thing here. The run action on clearing the selection will. Okay. So to start with, if you see to act as a filter, I was clicking. You agree? So I was clicking it. That was getting applied as a filter here or on the other sheet.
Okay.
Okay. So for the purpose of demo,
when
I'll click on.
Click and you are able to navigate to the drill down report.
Yes. So clicking means the select drill down. Over is nothing but, let's say I'll just click over. So I'm not really clicking on it. As soon as I just kept my mouse over it, it's just going there. It's kind of going very fast. Actually, West is not there. That's where the problem is.
But it is difficult, right? If you give it.
Yeah, we will not really do it. We will not really go with that option. But just know it is exist.
Yeah.
Menu means, like I click on menu. Okay. Menu means when you click it, nothing happens, but your tooltip, right? Remove this tooltip, right? That gets highlighted, and you could see that water name is there. So, Tableau itself took the name, you can rename it. So, for now, it's showing filter one generator. So, when I click it, then only that value is getting as a filter, is being sent as a filter to the other dashboard. So, it's something like a click only, but it's like two action click. So, click this. And then click again on this option, filter on generator. Then only it will go.
Okay? But here we can able to understand what values and what filters are being passed.
Yeah, you can. But this is kind of like a time consuming. So you could see from here also, south segment, or they can just keep the mouse and then click it. Which is what mostly we do. This menu option, rarely we'll go.
What is the filter to?
Sorry?
Cancel. What is the filter? Filter to dashboard actions.
That is for this one. This we created, we were trying yesterday, right? Filter 2 is nothing but from C2. This one is C2, it is passing to the other sheet, which we were just trying yesterday. So maybe if you're confused, we'll just remove it. But it's nothing but I clicked on this sheet and then clicked on this filter. That's it. Nothing else. Instead of here, I just click this and click this. So filter 2 was created. So for our understanding, I'm just removing it. This filter on generated, you can just rename it. Filter by, if you want, you can just add like category and or a region segment. So that's the name what your client will see on that menu option. So they'll see like filter by region and segment. And here, lastly, there's often called as run on single select only. So I'll click on the select. So run on single select is nothing but, so before I talk about this, I'll give okay. I have not enabled that option. So when I select multiple values, right? Those multiple values will be sent as filter. Okay, there's four values. Okay, or in this case, really, we don't have east and west. Only central and south will be sent as filter to the other sheet because the data is like that. Okay, so you don't want multiple values to be sent. So what you can do is just click on run on single select only. So what will happen is that Tableau will send only one data to the other sheet. It cannot
one
send multiple
value.
Yeah, one value or one combination of things. So if you see, when I click central consumer, it will go, okay? But when I select like this, let's say I'll select like this here. I selected four values, like maybe. I selected four values, it's not doing anything. So because of that option I selected, only one value can be clicked and only one value can be passed as a filter to the other sheet. When you select multiple, nothing's gonna happen. Okay, this also we rarely use it. But if you think they should view only one at a time, then you can enable this. But rare cases what we use this. Okay, just know it, it might be helpful for you. Okay.
Okay.
And next thing, at the bottom, if you see, there is something called as clearing the selection will. Okay. So before I talk about this option, let me show you here, or for the purpose of this thing, right? I'll
Raju, on. 1 second, give you 1 second done.
Yeah.
Hello.
Hello, yes.
Yes, okay.
Yeah. So this thing, right? Clearing the selection. So it's nothing but, let me show you, explain this, then I'll come. So for the purpose of understanding, I'll just click on this, like what to say. Click on this, say, instead of going to other sheet, I want to show it here itself. So that will be easier for me also to explain. So what I did is that I click on this, some particular value. That particular value is getting as filter applied, getting applied as a filter to the other sheet. Okay, when I click outside, okay, that is nothing but clearing the selection. Or I can either click on the same bar, or I can click on the white space. So when I click on white space, it is showing all the values here. Okay,
right.
So you can just select how do you want.
Where?
Yeah. So that will be selected by default. If you select, this will be selected by default. If you select something, it might change at the first time. So as I selected select first time, so it's not gonna really change, but just make sure. Show all values is what we really mostly use, but let me show you the other option. So leave the filter, right? So I'll just give okay. Okay. So I'll click on this South Corporate. It is getting applied. When I click outside, the filter gets applied. Like it's nice. I think we're like saving the filter or leaving the filter as it is. Okay. So when I click on something, that will be applied as a filter. When I click outside, it will not reset or it will not show all the values. That particular value which I selected last will
okay,
be saved.
It will not affect.
Yeah, it will not affect.
Okay.
So this also we rarely use it. Leave the filter, very rarely we use it, but know what
yes.
it does, what is the functionality. Okay. So last
okay.
option is exclude all values. So I'll click this. Okay. Okay. So if you click something, that will be getting applied as a filter. When you click outside, this will become empty. Okay, so only if someone clicks it, you will see the detail, else you will not see that. So this is kind of like a, like what, you are kind of restricting them to see only one at a time, or only when they click,
okay.
you will see, else they will not see like that. Okay. This we rarely use, like 90% of the time we will go this option.
Yeah.
Which is nothing but show all values.
Sure.
Sometimes you will exclude our values. Like leave the filter. I don't remember the use case where I use it. It'll be the rarest use option. So
yeah.
these two what option often. Okay.
Okay.
Okay. And this option we were talking yesterday. If you want to, instead of sending all the fields to the other sheet as a filter, if you want to specific, let's click this selected fields. Add filter and click whatever field you want. Let's say I want to send only a segment. You can just click the segment and give OK here. Okay. And remember, you can pass only the fields which is there in the view. So let's say I want to send a category field. In my case, I have only recent segment in the view. So if I give category, see what happens. Category. And give OK.
Okay.
So tab will say missing fields or recent sales, because you are saying to pass a category field does not even exist on the recent sales sheet, so it's going to give error or warning actually. So if you click, nothing's going to really happen. Okay, so best thing you do, add whatever field which is there in the view, or when you are
for suppose for suppose Raju, here state column is there in summary table, and then in the detail table we have state name column.
Okay.
So in this case, to make the filter work, is it possible to add it here, like source field is like state name and target field should be like say state like that,
State,
or
if you
always the
add,
day same names should be there.
yeah, the name should be same.
Data might be same. Data
The
might be same,
data,
but columns might be different, right?
you can rename it, right? You actually thing in dashboard is that data names also the values, it doesn't really care. It, if it is right, it will match. If not, it will be just blank. But the name should be matching, then it will work perfectly. Or you have to kind of manually, what to say, manual map it, but the manual mapping sometimes gets missed out. So mostly what we will make sure that they have the same names. That's it. Still.
Okay, so
you
then
can,
the
you can rename here, not do that. So here, right? So you can just click
but
the state.
There is an option source field.
You can just right click and rename
oh,
it.
Oh, I can rename it here directly here.
Yeah, yeah,
okay.
yeah. Do the table, it is different,
okay.
It doesn't matter. Here you have to just rename that. So
okay.
I think.
Oh, okay. We if we have this option, then also it's good on.
Yeah.
Okay. If the
so
names
you
are
can,
not same, if only if the table is same,
mm-hmm.
then I can go and rename in the Tableau, right? You're
yeah.
saying.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Because in Tableau, I agree that they have like the state name and data can be the same, but at least in Tableau, make sure that you can just rename it and have the same names.
Okay.
And one more thing here, I think that's it to talk on filter action. I'll talk about the other action now. But before that, I want to show you something. So state, right? If you see, state is not really, it's not a field in this view, okay? But it is a filter for these sheets, okay? If you want the state filter to be applied for the drill down also, you can just right click.
Yeah.
Like yesterday I taught you, right? Right click, apply to worksheets, selected
okay.
sheet. And here, click on this option called as show all worksheets in workbook. So if you
okay.
click it, you can see those sheets. So I want Tableau to apply this to sheet. So if you click this, so whatever I selected
okay.
here, the state or in this region. So for region also, I have to do the same. Let me show you that. All right. Apply to worksheets, select a sheets. Click on this option called as show all worksheets in workbook. And click on the underlying sheet. So sheet 3 is like sheet name. So if I give OK, so when I change something here, that will get applied to here also. So in my case, it's actually totally different. This is US data and that is Europe data. But assuming that you have the same data there, say data values are matching,
mm-hmm.
if you change the filter here, it will automatically get applied there. OK. So this
okay.
also you should know because you are using a two independent dashboard.
Two different
yeah.
data sources, yes.
Dashboard. Dashboard.
Yeah.
Not just data source, even if it is a drill down with from the same data source,
dashboard.
As they are different tabs, it's good to connect it. Okay. So you can use this option. These two options, I did not speak yesterday, but I'm talking now. So these two options, right? If I click all using this data source, so let's say I assume that you have like 10 dashboards, all the 10 dashboards will have this filter. Like, it's basically nothing but that will be applied there. It may not be. Yeah. If it is all using related data source, it will apply to all the data source if they have the same name. So if the state name exists in all the data sources, it will apply there. Okay. So mostly we will not use these two options because different dashboards have different filters. If you really want
yeah.
it, you can go ahead.
Yeah.
Let's say you want a dashboard which will filter out for a specific, let's say for a particular region. If you really want that, you can go ahead on using the all using related data source. If you feel no, it should be for only specific dashboards, then you have to go to this option called as select your worksheets and select those options that or select those sheets which you want this filter to be applied there. Okay. Clear?
Oh,
shall I move on?
Okay. Yes, yes.
Yeah, great. So coming back, so there are other actions,
mm-hmm.
which is just for you to know. It's something like this filter action itself is more than sufficient. So instead of I clicking here and say use as filter, you can just add action filter
mm-hmm.
to create a filter action. Okay, so this filter action we just now saw. Okay, so coming
okay.
back here. So there are other actions So we will be talking about this highlight action
So
and go to.
Tableau by default generated one filter, right?
Yes, yes,
So if
yes,
you
yes.
want to add it manually, means we have to provide all the source and the target sources, everything and all, right?
Yeah, it will be selected by default. You can see source is selected, target selected, and the selected menu. It gets selected automatically, but you can just customize it. So I want on select, I want on show all values. When someone clicks on recent sales, I want the video played on TV. So I can just select things manually if I want, but when you create something manually, Tableau will select something. So it's good to just customize it. Okay.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
So come back here. In add action, I want to talk about these two actions, which is called as highlight action and go to your election. So these are the other two actions. Okay. So this highlight option, right? So to explain this, let me create a new dashboard, like with the same set of things. So let's put region, let's put segment, let's put sales, and create the simple bar. Okay, this is one sheet. I'll duplicate this sheet. I click duplicate. So instead of segment, I'll put category. Or okay, for now let's have both the same. Okay, just for the purpose of example. But let's try with a different chart. Let's say why I'm right now. What I have is region, segment, sales. This is also region segment sales. Okay. I'll add more things to it later. But for now, it's in the same. They are exactly the same. But in different views or different charts. So I'll just put sheet 5 here. I'll put sheet 5 to inside. I'll make sure it is center view. I'll put center this name. Center view. I'll remove the filters for now. I don't want it. Last, if I want to delete, I'll just delete. Okay, now what I'm going to do is that for that filter act highlight action, you have to go to dashboard actions, add action, highlight. There's no shortcut for this, this is the only way. Add action, highlight. So it looks something like that filter action window. It's kind of works like it, but in a little different way. So instead of adding as a filter, it's gonna just highlight on the other sheet. That's it. The job is simple, as the name says. It's gonna highlight on the other sheet. Okay, so let's just leave it as it is. I'll come back. I'll just go okay. So when I click here, so let's say I'll try this central home office. So instead of I going and searching on the sheet, if I click this, it gets highlighted on the other dashboard or other worksheet. Okay.
Okay.
So it's basically its job is nothing but when you click on something, it gets highlighted on the other sheet. That's it. Simple. The job is very simple. Just highlight it.
Okay.
Okay. Yeah. So.
But instead of now completely moving to the sheet. Okay.
Yeah.
It will just highlight.
Yeah. So it's basically nothing but there should be at least one field common. In this case, I intentionally kept both the fields common. Segmentation is there. Segmentation is there. So let's now change something. Or let me add something here. Let me add customer name here. Like too many things, but it's showing at a customer level. Okay, so it is region, segment, customer name. Okay, so when I click consumer central, whatever it is common, it will highlight that. So this is nothing but for different customers, for but region consumer thing. Or when I click on East Corporate, right? So these are the customers of East Corporate. So it will highlight only the common things. So as I said, at least one field should
come
be common.
We got many squares.
I added the custom name to the label. Sheet. I added it. I went to sheet 52 and
but
I added the custom label.
So,
yeah, that's why. Or getting this kind of confusion, let's add category. But still, I'm doing it because I want to have multiple things. So when you click on this East Corporate, you are seeing three boxes, nothing but for different categories. Make sense?
Okay. Yes, yes.
So here, right, let me Let me remove the segment.
Mm.
So when I remove it, when I click on corporate central, as we not really have the
mm-hmm.
segment here, it's just going to highlight the region. That's it. Okay, so only if there is a one common column, it will get highlighted. If there is no common column, it will be just gray in color. It will not really highlight anything. Its job is just to highlight it if there is a common dimension. That's it. I think it makes sense.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. So here I'll go dashboard actions. Just highlight. I'll edit it. Double click it. So I'll get this window. Here also you can select it. It's exactly like what we do in the filter action. Whether I want to run when we hover on it,
mm-hmm.
we select it, or should they select on the menu? Okay. So mostly highlight. It's good to have on either of these, either on hover or select. Okay. So hover should be fine because we'll have like what one action in one option will be better. So select is for filter, and hover is for highlight.
Mm-hmm.
Or you can have both in the menu. You can have both in menu, it will still work fine. That will be perfect. But you have to click it and then select whether they want to highlight or they want to filter. Okay. And source and target is the
mm-hmm.
same. You can have other shift also. That's what they have the option. This last thing, right? Target highlighting. It's something like the target filter which we saw. You can just select the field which you want to highlight. So I want to highlight only region. Or I want to highlight only category. Okay. So I'll just click category.
Okay.
So if you see, when I click on something, I do not have category in this other sheet. That's why it's not highlighting. Okay. Or to
okay.
say correctly, I do not have category here. Okay. So let's go to the sheet 5. I'll add the category. Add it here. So I'll click on something. If you see that
okay.
I clicked on office supply, so all the office supply in this same sheet, also the other sheet is getting highlighted. Okay. So if there are common fields, it will get highlighted. That's it, nothing else. I mean common dimensions. Okay.
Mm-hmm.
And I set it to category. So that category is getting highlighted. Make sense? Just know it. Rarely we'll use this,
yeah.
but it's a good option. This highlight is a good option when you have like two different sheets where you, instead of you going and searching it, you can just click it to highlight on the other sheet. Something simple and looks.
Mm-hmm.
Fine.
Okay. Yeah, fine.
Yeah. So that's it on highlight action. Shall I move on?
One second.
Yeah.
Okay. Highlighting. Selector fields, right? Okay.
Okay. So next thing, right? What I want to talk about is called as go to URL. Okay. So go to URL is nothing but okay. Let's try a new sheet. Let's try something interesting. Let's try state. It's nothing but when you click on it, it'll go to some URL or go to some hyperlink. That's it, nothing else. It will open a new web page or it'll you can have it in a tab browser. I'll show you them both. So I'll just create a simple chart. Or if you want, I can have it in map also. I'll go to map then.
State, okay.
State map.
Okay.
Yeah, this map also looks neat. So I'll go to new dashboard.
Okay.
I'll use the sheet 7. I'll go to automatic. I'll remove the legend for now. So here, right, I'll just click on this dashboard, actions, add action, go to URL. So when someone clicks on sheet 7, when they select it,
okay.
So just click here, it should be fine. You should go to some website. So let's say I want to go to www.google.com/. There is some keyword. I'll
mm-hmm.
just trying it. I'm not sure if it's what I'm doing is right. I have to check it, but let's see if it works. So I'll just select. I'll just give the link www.google.com search q equal to, and click the small arrow and select the field which you want to be the substitute search state. So what will happen is that when someone clicks on a particular state, Tableau will go to this www.google.com
mm-hmm.
and it will search the particular state. It will substitute here and it will search it. Let's see if it works.
Mm-hmm.
Click on screen. Let's see if it works. I'll give it a try. I think it is working perfect. So as I was kind of playing with it, I knew that this is what the syntax, but you can also search yourself. Say, let's say I want to go to YouTube or I want to go to Wikipedia.
These things and all, can you mention it in all? No, okay.
Sorry, which one?
This syntax is what you have tried, right?
Yeah. Now the syntax, right? That's what I'm trying to change. I'm trying to memorize or trying to search it. You go to a particular website, any website, okay? Just search for some unknown big word, maybe. SDSD, like that. Give us, okay. So if you are able to find that word, can you see here? Yeah, whatever you type, it should be somewhere here. Okay.
Yes, yes.
So you just copy that link, even if you do for Google. So even if you go for google.com, go to google.co.in, I'm searching for something. As soon as I say click it, you can see it here. So here it is coming.
Yeah.
Okay.
So till
yeah. Yeah. As I was kind of playing this thing for a very long time, I'm kind of confident that the search queue, search question mark queue is sufficient. No need of this extra HP, blah, 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 blah. It's just unrelated things. But if you're unsure, just copy the whole thing. You copy the whole thing, go here and just paste it here. Sorry, control V, paste it. And you just go to the sorting. This instead of ASD, 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 just delete them and place that state here. Let's give the test link. Let's see if it works. It's see Alabama. It's tribal, it's automatically substituting a random state name there. So it's working fine. So if you're not sure what to remove and what not to remove, it's good to leave it as this. But in my case, I have played with this link a lot of time. So I'm just removing this. We don't really need it. All we need is this google.co.in/search q equal to state. That's it. Okay. Nothing else to change here. Okay. And okay. So when I click on some state, so let's click on sub Dakota. When I click it, Tableau is opening that web page in your browser, in your default browser, with its state names searched in the Google, and you're seeing the output of that particular thing. Okay. So what you can use this, or where you can use this, if you ask me the use case, right? You can use it, let's assume that you have an internal website. You, when you click on some task or something, it should go and search for the task details. Let's say you have a web page, and one more thing, that word should come in your hyperlink or in your URL. If it doesn't really come there, then it's not really going to work out. But if it comes, then you're lucky, you can use on this URL action. Okay. Some web pages, when you click, when you search something, it will not come on this URL. It is designed such a way that then you cannot really do, you cannot do nothing about it. But let's, most of the web pages, when you search for something,
this is web page.
Yeah, it is a web page. It's a new web page. It's a or it's a new tab, new browser.
See, this is web page. We can do it. But if we want to navigate to the some application, like for this particular detail, if they want to see the source details related to that particular statement, so they might be having some source application like C, GRM, or some other applications which they were using, right? So in that case, how can I do that?
Okay.
In the same way.
So, yeah, if it is a desktop application, I think you cannot do nothing about it. Okay. So let's say you have a software installed. I haven't really tried much of CRM, but assuming that if it's a desktop application, it's like another software like Syllabus, you cannot make Tableau to send that value there. But if it is a web application, okay, so if you, the CRM is gonna be accessed through a web link, okay, so go to that web link, search for that something. If you think you are able to get the link like this, okay, so even Google is a web application, okay, so even without logging in, Google is able to get it. So if the CRM also without logging, if you are able to find this particular like this link, then you can try it, okay. So only this is gonna work if it is a URL, if it's a hyperlink. If it's a desktop application, you cannot do nothing about it. You cannot make Tableau to send that value there. But if it's a web application, you can, and if you're able to find that URL where, let's say this is your CRM, you are searching for something, and whatever you search comes here. So you're lucky, you can copy this link and you can come here. Okay. But as I said, it's just gonna go for hyperlink or for a URL only. Cannot pass value to a desktop application. Even if it is an Excel file, Tableau cannot send some value to an Excel.
Desktop application, since it will be having the signing in, logins, everything.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Even web application, if it is a, what is it? If it is automatically signed in, SQL sign on or something, or Windows authentication. Or at least someone should have logged in once, at least once. So when they click it, it's gonna create a new web page with those particular link up or whatever you give here, which is a task or whatever it is.
Yeah, if it is already logged in, then we could able to move.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
I got.
And one more thing to add here, this thing yet, nothing to show here, but there is something called as this objects, okay? So in this object, I was using the text object yesterday. So there is something called as web page, okay? So this web page, right? If I just drag and drop and place it here, so here I just give okay, nothing. Mm-hmm. If you want to give some default website, you can give it here or just give okay. So when you have this web page object on the view itself, on the dashboard itself, so when someone clicks this, so instead of Tableau, taking it to a new browser, it will just open the result inside Tableau itself. So this will be useful, but you will end up with a scroll bar. That's something you should note. Okay, or maybe.
So in this case, we need not to give any URL in add actions.
Sorry, come again. Add action, you should give.
In this.
You should give. That's how Tableau is kind of navigating. You should give it, but instead of Tableau going to the new browser, it is just showing here.
What URL
should be there. That is how Tableau is knowing it, what to send or what to search for. So which URL to go.
Okay.
Yeah. So if you use this web page object, Tableau show the result here itself. If you remove this, it'll open in a new tab. That's the small thing. Okay.
Okay.
Yeah. So lastly, in the actions, I wanted to talk about this called as this go-to sheet. This go-to sheet is something pretty straightforward, as the name says. When you click on something, you go to other sheet. That's it. So when someone clicks on sheet 7, dashboard 7, it has to go to dashboard 3. That's it. Nothing else. You got the idea? There's no filter. There's nothing. So when someone clicks on, I'll remove this hyperlink. To just save the confusion, I'll click this. If I'll click on add action and go to sheet, I'll get this window where it says when someone clicks on dashboard 4, it should go to dashboard 3. So I'll just give okay and okay. So when I click here, nothing really passes a filter here, but it's just navigating from one sheet to other sheet. That's it. Okay.
Mm-hmm.
So let's say I have like the sheet, when someone clicks it, it just have to go to
that's it. We can't pass any filters, sir.
Yeah, if you want filter, then you have to go with filter action, obviously. If you do not want it, you just want you just want to travel from one sheet without anything, then you can use the go to sheet option. Okay. This is
so
a
what
new
is the use of this go to sheet then?
So it's just to move from one sheet to other. Let's say it can be used like a back button, or it can be used like a home button. Let's say, okay, let me show you something. So let me show here. I haven't touched the calculator field, but let's try here. Let's say or go to dashboard. Sorry for the caps. Calculation one. So here I'll put in text. So it will be shown here. I'll make this bigger. So I'll do sheet 8. I'll place it here. You can place it at the top. Maybe. Okay, I'll place it at the top. I'll hide this thing. So it can be like, you can have icons also if you want. Icons in other way, you can have different shapes. Okay, you can go to this shapes and then change shapes if you want. But for now, let's have it. Okay, we got that. So let's use shape also. It's not more shapes. Click here and say maybe back button. Something like this. Press back. Back. Something like this. Okay, so I'll go to this dashboard actions. Here, I'll just select sheet 8. Sheet is nothing but it's a sheet where I have created a field called as go to dashboard 3, some icon. So I'll just give okay and okay. So when I click here, click on this icon, it just goes to this dashboard. That's it. Just like a navigation button. So navigation button does not, Tableau does not really have it. So you can just create the sheet with some text there, and when someone clicks that sheet, it goes to the other dashboard. So you can have multiple multiple sheets like this. But remember, you have to create a dummy field which has a static text there. Okay, then you should be able to create a sheet with some name or some value there. Give some icon if you want to. When you create this dashboard actions, go to sheet option. So when you click it, it's just gonna traverse to the other sheet. That's it. Just pretty straightforward and simple. Just to create a navigation button kind of style, just like what you see in the other pages, right? Index page will be there. So if you click something, it will go to the other page. So you can just create like that. Or maybe the best use case I can give is that, let's say you are on detail page, instead of them going on the tabs, you want that them to go back to the summary dashboard just directly, then you can use this go to sheet option, which will be like a smaller name or small icon on the top. So they just click on that the details tab, it will take them to the summary dashboard. Make sense?
So after coming to the detail report again, if user wants to select for the different value means, definitely it is necessary to provide the back button there. In that case, it will be helpful. That's what you're saying, right?
Yes, exactly. So they can just click on the different tabs. They can just switch it, but it will be like what? It's like a small option they're given, that instead of them having to traverse the things, they can just click here. It's just a shortcut like that.
Okay.
That's it. Dashboard and action. I'm just thinking. So new topic. If you start right now, we don't have time. So I think let's stop here. You try this.
So dashboards, have we complete? Yeah, I'll try today.
Yeah. Dashboard is just nothing but you place your sheets, you give some actions. These were.
The so dashboard. To place sheets and objects, that's it. And prompts. Okay. That is phone and all was there. What is that?
It's for the different layout. Like, how will it look when someone views this in a phone? How will it look like for someone, let's say, what's that? We'll find something is active.
Okay, then that's fine.
Yeah,
my laptop also is going to get switch off.
Okay. It's okay. There are a few other options, small options, but let's talk at the very end. If you want, if you're really interested, I'll just talk about these options. But without using this option also, if you want some image, if you want some blank space, you can use this. It's just pretty straightforward. Okay, maybe give it a try. If you have, maybe try this option, this file, tiled floating.
Tiled floating, what is this? I didn't
Okay. So, a tile is nothing but when you drag and drop something, it will be placed here. When I click on floating and drag and drop something, it will be just floating there. Like I can see 370, just a sheet 4. You can you see it here? It is just floating there. It's not really placed in the sheet, but it's just overlapping. If you want to overlapping something, you can use this floating option here. Get it?
Okay.
Yeah.
Sorry, I missed
that. I was saying that. Let's say you click on floating. You click on the sheet 4 and drag and drop, it will not be really placed in the sheet, it will not be placed in between the sheet or bottom or top, it will be just hanging like a overlaying. Okay, mostly will not do it because you kind of hide things. Okay, so you barely use it. Maybe you can try like text. I want a text which is there. I want something there, then it might be helpful. So it's something like this, but there is a disadvantage to floating because especially when I'm using automatic, right? This will move automatically. Okay, this portion of this thing, as it is a floating object, you can move, you can come here, it can come here, then as your screen is going changes. So try to avoid floating object, but if you use floating objects just to overlay up on something, it's like a sticker. You draw something, you're just sticking out on your table or sticking on your dashboard.
Okay, fine.
Try these objects. If you have anything, we'll talk about it.
Yes.
but it's not really as important
Okay,
as that.
sure.
Okay, then we'll see you tomorrow. Bye.
Thank you.
Bye.
Thank you.